Okay, so let's jump into solving an example problem. We're given a 2 kilogram mass pulley with a radius of 0.4 meters, and attached to that is a 3 kilogram mass. We're going to try and solve for the acceleration of the hanging mass as it falls. Now, in order to start solving this problem, I'm going to go ahead and begin by drawing a force diagram on the pulley and the mass, just as we did before when analyzing connected objects systems. If we look at the hanging mass, we could say that there is a force that the Earth exerts on the hanging mass, otherwise known as the force of gravity on the mass, and that would be equal to m times g, right? The mass of the hanging mass multiplied by our acceleration due to gravity. And then what's resisting gravity in this case would be the tensional force in that rope, and so that's going to be tension in the rope. And now when it comes to the pulley, right, we can think of the pulley, the hanging mass is pulling down on the pulley with that tensional force. So that tension is also acting on the pulley just as the tension is acting on the mass. This bracket right here is keeping the pulley upright. So we could call this like a, you know, normal force, Fn of the bracket essentially. And the pulley has mass now. So we're also going to show this gravitational force of the pulley coming from the center of mass of the pulley, which could be the center of the pulley. Now, in this case, we're not going to really have to consider either of these forces, the mass of the pulley, the weight force that is, or the bracket's supportive force, because those forces will be equal to each other, right? They're going to balance each other out. We're not going to worry about those forces when we look at our system of equations and our force diagrams. We're going to omit those. We're only going to have to consider the force of tension on the pulley and then those two forces on the hanging mass, okay? So if I want to know the acceleration of the hanging mass, we know that we can use Newton's second law for translational motion about the hanging mass. So for the hanging mass, the sum of forces on that, if we go ahead and define the direction of acceleration, or in other words, the downward direction to be positive, then that would be mg minus tension, right? And that would be equal to the mass of the pulley times a, the acceleration, the mass of the hanging mass, little m, and multiplied by a. We're going to use a big m for the mass of the pulley, and we'll see where that comes up later. All right, so that means that my acceleration, right, if I wanted to rearrange this, I could. My acceleration of the hanging mass would be mg, the weight force on the hanging mass, minus the tensional force in the rope, divided by the mass of the hanging mass. Now, I don't know the tension in the rope, and so I can't continue solving this problem. I need to solve for tension before I'm able to proceed any further, or get one more equation that has tension and acceleration in it so I can have a system of two equations. Well, it just so happens that we can also use Newton's second law, the rotational form, about the pulley. Right, so if this is my pulley, I'll go ahead and just draw it separately here. And I have some sort of tension in this rope. That rope is acting like a torque, right? That's what causes the pulley to spin in the first place, is the fact that this rope is, you know, pulling on the pulley and creates a torque. This is one distance r away from the center because the rope is at the edge of the pulley. And so if I'm trying to solve for the torque that the hanging mass or the tensional force in that rope exerts, the torque here, right? So the torque in the rope, or torque provided by the rope, would be equal to the tensional force multiplied by R. And we could multiply by sine of 90 degrees here because they are perpendicular. We're going to see that it goes away, right? The perpendicular component, right? This would be that perpendicular component. There is only one component. It's all perpendicular. We don't need to worry about any sine or cosine angle here. So we just have that the torque produced by that tensional force is equal to that tensional force multiplied by R, which is this distance. Okay. And I know that the sum of torques, this is Newton's second law, but in rotational form, right, is equal to, right, that's just the one torque. Okay. And that's going to be equal to the moment of inertia times alpha of the pulley. Right? This is Newton's second law in rotational form. This was Newton's second law in translational form. So I'll say Newton's second law, translational. And this is Newton's second law in rotational form. So we're using Newton's second law in both rotational and translational terms to solve this problem. If I wanted then to go ahead and get alpha in terms of a, right? Because I already have an equation over here with a, acceleration of the hanging mass, linear, and t, tension. I don't want alpha. That's another unknown. So I'm going to use my expression that a, the linear acceleration of the hanging mass, is equal to r, the radius of the pulley, multiplied by alpha, the angular acceleration of the pulley. Or in other words, right, alpha is equal to a over r. I rearrange there. So that means that the torque, or the tensional force, times the radius of the pulley, in other words, the torque on the pulley, will be equal to the moment of inertia of the pulley multiplied by a over r. And now I can go ahead and rearrange this for t. I'm going to just divide both sides by r. And that'll give me that the tension in the rope is equal to I times A over R, and that's all over R. And that looks a bit ugly. We can actually clean that up a little bit if we know that the moment of inertia for a disc, which we can assume the pulley is like a cylinder or a disc, is going to be 1/2 big M, mass of the pulley, and the radius of the pulley squared. So if I plug that in for the moment of inertia, and then I go ahead and simplify. The r squared on the top will cancel with this r on the bottom, right? That'll just become r. And then I can divide by r, right? R divided by r will go away. And so the r, the radius of the pulley, ends up becoming insignificant. And we get that the tension in the rope is 1/2 the mass of the pulley times the linear acceleration of the hanging mass. And so if this is tension, right, I can take this whole thing, this is t, right? And I can plug that in right here into my equation. So I'll get A is equal to mg minus 1/2 ma all over small m of the hanging mass. And now, in this case, I'm going to have to rearrange to solve for A. I have A on both sides of my equation, so maybe it wasn't the best idea to rearrange before, but that's no problem at all. I'll multiply back by m on both sides, so I'll get, it'll be ma equals mg minus 1/2 big M times A, right, mass of the pulley. I'll move those over to one side and factor out. And so I'll get A, M plus 1/2 M is equal to MG. And then I'll divide and I'll get this as my final expression. The linear acceleration of the hanging mass is equal to MG, the weight force on the hanging mass, divided by the hanging mass plus 1/2 the mass of the pulley. That is my final expression. Once I took my second equation over here, this is number 2, and I plugged it into my first equation, number 1, I got this expression. And this is my final answer for the acceleration of the hanging mass. I can go ahead and plug in my values now. So that would be 2 kilograms times 9.8, right, my constant, and that would be, oh, I'm sorry, that is not 2, right? We're using the mass of the small, the hanging mass, not the mass of the pulley, so be careful here. The mass of the hanging mass was 3 kilograms. G is always 9.8. That would be 3 plus 1/2 times 2 on the bottom. That means that our acceleration would be equal to 7.35 meters per second squared. And that is our numerical answer. All right, so to recap, in order to solve this problem, we drew force diagrams for both the pulley and the hanging mass separately, and we applied Newton's second law for translational and rotational motion to each object. So translational in the case of the hanging mass and the rotational form for the pulley. We were able to get two equations relating the tension in the rope and the acceleration A of the hanging mass, which was also related to alpha, the angular acceleration of the pulley. And we used these two equations to solve for the acceleration of the hanging mass as it fell. Now I want to point out that because I made the direction here down to be positive, I also defined this direction on the pulley, so this would be counterclockwise, I also defined that to be positive as well. It's important that they're going in the same direction. So if the pulley is rotating, you know, counterclockwise as the mass is falling down, then I want to make sure that those are both defined to be positive. Or they could both be negative, but in this case, it's a bit easier to work with them as both positive. So we made sure to define our directions when we solve this problem also to be the same depending on how the system was accelerating. Okay, let's take a look at solving the same problem, but this time using conservation of energy.